Hi students, Namaskaram. Now we are entering into our 14th problem. This problem is based upon the exempted capital gain under section 54B. Shahid sells agricultural land situated in Delhi city for ₹61 lakh on May 15, 2019, which was purchased by him in June 2004 for ₹11 lakh 30,000. The year of purchase is 2004 and therefore the asset was held by the assessee for more than 24 months. Then it is long-term capital asset. Continue reading. On 1st April 2020, he purchased agricultural land for ₹20 lakh and deposited ₹6 lakh in capital gain account scheme in order to get exemption under section 54B. He avails exemption under section 54B because he purchases another agricultural land and deposits the capital gain under capital gain account scheme 1988. He purchased another agricultural land on 30th April 2021 for ₹5,50,000 by withdrawing from deposit account. By withdrawing from the deposit account, he purchased another land for ₹5,50,000. And if the balance amount of the capital gain account scheme is withdrawn in October 2021, compute the capital gains for the assessment years 2020-21 and 2022-23. First of all, we shall compute the capital gain for the previous year 2019-20, that is the assessment year 2020-21. First of all, we have to see what is sale consideration. Shahid sells agricultural land situated in Delhi city for ₹61 lakh. This 61 lakh is the sale consideration. 61 lakh. As it is long-term capital asset, deduct indexed cost of acquisition. The asset was purchased by the assessee in June 2004, that is in the previous year 2004-05, for ₹11 lakh 30,000. It is the cost of acquisition. And we have to find out indexed cost acquisition. 11,30,000 into index for the previous year 2019-20 289 divided by index for the year of purchase 2004-05 113. 11,30,000 into 289 divided by 113. We get 28,90,000. This is the indexed cost acquisition. Okay. Deduct it, we get 32,10,000 as long-term capital gain. The assessee purchases another agricultural land for ₹20 lakh and deposited ₹6 lakh in capital gain account scheme. The aggregate of these two amounts is allowed as exemption under section 54B. That is, the exemption under section 54B is the aggregate of amount of capital gain utilized for the purchase of agricultural land plus deposited in capital gain account scheme. That is ₹20 lakh plus ₹6 lakh, ₹26 lakh, less exemption under section 54B. Land purchased ₹20 lakh plus amount deposited in capital gain account scheme ₹6 lakh, total ₹26 lakh. Now we get ₹6,10,000 being taxable long-term capital gain for the assessment year 2020-21. And during April 2021, that is in the previous year 2021-22, he purchased another agricultural land for ₹5,50,000 by withdrawing from deposit account. We deposited ₹6 lakh in the capital gain account scheme, which was allowed as a deduction. Now, ₹6 lakh under 2019-20 capital gain account scheme deposited in the exemption. Out of this 6 lakh, he utilized ₹5,50,000 and there is balance of ₹50,000. That unutilized amount is taxable. Okay. Amount deposited in capital gain account scheme during the previous year 2019-20, 6 lakh. Less amount utilized for the acquisition of land, ₹5,50,000. There is balance amount ₹50,000. It is taxable as long-term capital gain for the assessment year 2022-23. By withdrawing from the deposit account, he purchased another land for ₹5,50,000 during 2021-22. And a balance amount in the capital gain account scheme is withdrawn in October 2021. Therefore, that balance amount is taxable. That is, 6 lakh amount deposited, deduct ₹5,50,000 is the amount utilized for the acquisition land. The balance ₹50,000 is taxable in the assessment year 2022-23. So, thank you.